भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्यं नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयत् मुदीरये नष्टप्रायेष्व भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्टिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। सो वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 7 एंड वर्स नंबर 7 एज वेल। अधाशयनस्य शिशो अनकल्पका प्रवाल मृदुवंग्रिहतां व्यवर्तत विधवास्तनानरसकुप्यभाजनम् व्यत्यस्तचक्राक्षविभिन्नकुभरम्। अदाशयनस्य who was put underneath the hand cart, shishaha of the child, anaha the cart, alpaka not very much grown, pravala just like a new leaf, mrudu angrihatam struck by his beautiful delicate legs, vyavartata turned over and fell down, vidhavasta scattered, nanaras kupyabhajanam utensils made of various metals, vyatyasya dislocated, chakra aksha the two wheels and the axle, vibhinna broken, kubharam the pole of the hand cart. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Lord Shri Krishna was lying down underneath the hand cart in one corner of the courtyard, and although his little legs are as soft as the leaves, when he struck the cart with his legs, it turned over violently and collapsed. The wheels separated from the axle, the hubs and the spokes fell apart, and the pole of the hand cart broke. On the cart there were many little utensils made of various metals, and all of them scattered hither and thither. Purport. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has commented on this verse as follows. When Lord Krishna was of a very tender age, his hands and legs resembled soft new leaves. Yet simply by touching the hand cart with his legs, he made the cart fall to pieces. It was quite possible for him to act in this way and yet not exert himself very much. The Lord in the Vamana Avatar had to extend his foot to the greatest height to penetrate the covering of the universe, and when the Lord killed the gigantic demon Hiranyakashipu, he had to assume the special bodily feature of Narasimhadev. But in this Krishna Avatar, the Lord did not need to exert such energy. Therefore, Krishnastu Bhagavan Swayam. Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself. In other incarnations, the Lord had to exert some energy according to the time and circumstances. But in this form, He exhibited unlimited potency. Thus, the handcart collapsed, its joints broken, and all the metal parts and utensils scattered. The Vaishnava Toshani remarks that although the handcart was higher than the child could easily touch the wheels of the cart, and this was sufficient to send the demon down to the earth. The Lord simultaneously pushed the demon to the earth and superficially broke the handcart. Om Ajnanatimirandhasya Jnananjanam Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Guruve Namaha Mukam Karoti Vachalam Pangum Langayate Giram Yat Kripatamaham Vande Sri Gurum Dinatarinam Paramananda Madhavam Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Prashtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Deve Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Pashyat Deshatarine Nityanandamaham Nami Sarvananda Karamparam Harinama Pradam Deva Mamaduta Shiramanim Ananda Lila Maya Vigrahaya Hemamba Divya Visundaraya Tasmai Mahabrem Rasabradaya Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Jai Sri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhakta Vranda Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Ram 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 Hare Hare So before I begin, I want to sincerely offer my respectful obeisances unto all the devotees who are assembled here. And I wish to sincerely thank the management for giving me a chance to glorify Krishna and purify my existence. Thank you very much. So Srila Parikshit Maharaj, he heard from Sukadeva Goswami the pastimes of deliverance of Putana. And the last verse, when Sukadeva Goswami glorified the pastimes of Lord Krishna, and he said that Ya etat Putana moksham Krishnasya arbhakam adbhutam Shunyach shaddayo martyo Govinda Labhate Ratan. He made a point in this. He said, any person who hears with faith and devotion about how Krishna, the Supreme Lord, killed Putana, and how and who thus invests his hearing in such childhood pastimes of Krishna, what does he get? He gets that his mind fixed up in Lord Govinda. Here, Sukadeva Goswami says, Krishnasya arbhakam adbhutam. So Sukadeva Goswami is using the word adbhutam, means wonderful, specifically very wonderful. Now, that this incident of Putana, which was covered in the last chapter, in which the Supreme Lord killed Putana, she came to kill Krishna, but she herself got killed. So, we can see in this pastimes how Krishna is very merciful. How Krishna has been very kind. Otherwise, if someone comes to kill you, will you give him a position in your room, in your house, in your life? No. But somebody is coming to kill Krishna, and Krishna in return is giving her a position of a mother in the spiritual world. She was not a devotee. She was a demon. Putana was a demon. But she came disguised as a devotee. And still Krishna gave her a position of a mother. So by which we can understand that this pastimes actually exhibits the mercy of Lord Krishna. And also we can come to know that Krishna doesn't see the dark side of a person. He only saw that she came to Braj, she came to Vrindavan, and she came disguised as a gopi. and she wanted to feed me breast milk. So these are all, and she was wearing a dress of Mother Yashoda. So Krishna, seeing her external appearance and being very kind to her, being very merciful to her, and without seeing her dark side, Krishna delivered her, killed her, purified her, and then gave her a position of a mother in the spiritual world. So Krishna has left us many wonderful narrations about him in Srimata Bhagavatam. So simply by hearing these narrations which are described in Srimata Bhagavatam, what happens? One gains salvation from this material world and gradually develops attachment for Lord Govinda. That's our goal, to develop attachment. Govinda labhate ratim. Always remember Krishna, never forget Krishna. So we want to fix our mind in Krishna. So Shukdeva Goswami is saying that hearing the pastimes of Lord Krishna, what happens? Govinda labhate ratim. Our mind becomes fixed in Krishna. So Maharaj Parikshit, when he heard these pastimes of deliverance of Putana, he became very pleased and satisfied in his heart, and he said to Shukdeva Goswami. What did he say? He said, Ena ena avatarena bhagavan haririshvara karoti karna ramyani manogyani chana prabho. So Parikshit Maharaj is saying, Ena ena avatarena bhagavan haririshvara. Oh, my dear Shukdeva Goswami, my dear Gurudev, that you have narrated to me so many different wonderful pastimes from various incarnations. And how are these pastimes? Karana Ramyani. He is saying that these pastimes are very pleasing to the ears. When we hear Krishna Katha, we get a kind of satisfaction. Karana Ramyani. And then what happens? Parikshit Maharaj is saying, not only Karana Ramyani, but Manahajnani. It has been very attractive to the mind. And then he further says that anyone who simply hears these narrations, what happens? Yat Shunvanta Apiti. Apiti means vanishes. What vanishes? Aratihi. Unattractiveness. If we have no attraction for Krishna, so if we hear such pastimes of the Lord again and again, we will develop attraction for Krishna. So what vanishes after hearing such pastimes? Aratihi. Aratihi will be converted to ratihi. So, and then what he says further? With Krishna, the dirty things within the mind that makes us uninterested in Krishna consciousness, that goes away. And further Maharaj Parikshit says, Sattvam ta shuddhye arichena pumsam. And what more vanishes? One attachments for hearing about material things. Now hearing about the material things is the root cause of material existence. We have desire to hear about material world. That's why our material existence continues. When we desire to hear about Krishna, then we'll develop attraction for Krishna and then we'll attain Krishna. And what happens? Once attachment for hearing about material things goes away, and bhaktir harau tat purusheja sakhyam. One gradually develops devotional service to the Supreme Lord. One gradually develops attachment towards him and friendship with his devotees. So everything happens by hearing. So hearing is the base. Hearing in Navaida Bhakti, hearing is the first, kept as first thing. Why? Because hearing is the base. So Parikshit Maharaj mentions that the wonderful activities of baby Krishna, which amazed even Mother Yashoda and other inhabitants of Vraja, are very, very attractive. And from the beginning of his childhood, Krishna killed Putana, Krishna killed Ranavat, Krishna killed Shaktasur, and he showed the entire universe within his mouth. Now these pastimes, one after another, kept Mother Yashoda, not only Mother Yashoda and Nanda Baba, but all the Brajavasis in great astonishment. So everybody was astonished by by hearing this, by seeing these wonderful pastimes of Lord Krishna. And especially now Parikshit is hearing those, he is also getting greatly astonished. And all the assembled great personalities who are sitting in that assembly are also getting greatly astonished. Now, what is the process of reviving our consciousness, our Krishna consciousness? The process to revive our consciousness is Adav Shraddha Tatha Sadhu Sangaha. Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, it says this. Now, the pastimes of the Lord, the pastimes, the glories, activities, forms of the Lord can be very properly received from devotees, from Sadhu Sangha. If we sit in the association of the devotees, we will hear Krishna Katha from them. Usually when we get a chance to associate with Sadhu, we put forward so many questions to him which are not relevant to Krishna consciousness or not even relevant to our life. He is saying that, he is saying this, he is saying that. So when we get a fortune to associate with the Sadhu, we put forward so many questions that are not relevant even to our Krishna consciousness. This politician said this and that. This has nothing to do with us. So Sadhu might reply one or two questions, but the actual benefit we cannot derive just by asking such questions to him. Actual benefit can be derived if we ask questions about Krishna. So whenever we get a chance to associate with Sadhus, we should inquire about Krishna consciousness, we should inquire about Srimad Bhagavatam. When we get Sadhu Sangha, what happens in Sadhu Sangha? Krishna Katha is discussed. And what is the main source of Krishna Katha is Srimad Bhagavatam. So, if one has developed a little bit of Krishna consciousness, what will he do? He will go and hear from the Vaishnavas about what? About the activities, form and pastimes about Krishna. And what will happen? One will develop attachment for Krishna and also one will develop attachment for devotees. So, Parikshit Maharaj is recommending here. Usually Shukadeva Goswami is speaking and Parikshit, everybody is listening. But here, after hearing the pastimes of Krishna, here Parikshit Maharaj is actually indicating to all of them who are sitting there in the assembly and also to us. What is he saying? That he is recommending that one hears the childhood pastimes of Krishna, which are more attractive than the activities of any other incarnations which are mentioned before. Parikshit Maharaj heard the first 9 cantos. So now he is concluding. What is he concluding? That just by hearing this little pastimes of birth of Lord Krishna and deliverance of Putana, Maharaj Parikshit is saying that these are more attractive than the incarnations of Matsya, Kurma and Varaha. And wanting to hear more and more from Shukadeva Goswami, Maharaj Parikshit is requesting him that please continue narrating Krishna Katha, the childhood pastimes of the Lord. And he is expressing his inquisitiveness. He is expressing his lalasa. If we don't have the lalasa for hearing, what should we do? What should we do? So to increase our lalasa, we have to hear more and more and more. If we have no taste for chanting, what will we do? Not chant. No. We have to chant more, more, more and more. So similarly, if you don't have taste for chanting, what should we do? If one doesn't have taste for hearing, what should we do? Hear more and more and more and more. So this is what Maharaj Parikshit is recommending, that we should hear more and more. And now, with this desire to hear more and more, Maharaj Parikshit is requesting Shukadeva Goswami, dear Gurudev, please continue. It's very important. It was very important that Parikshit Maharaj is also encouraging Shukadeva Goswami. And he is thanking him in one sense that he has been grateful to Shukadeva Goswami that he is taking so much efforts and pain to speak Harikatha. And this is causeless mercy of Shukadeva Goswami. That Maharaj Parikshit is on the verge of death. 7 days he had only with him. And then because he was a sincere devotee of the Lord, Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, he sent Shukadeva Goswami for his deliverance. When Maharaj Parikshit took birth, in the womb of his mother, Ashwatthama made an attempt to kill him. And Lord Krishna personally entered the womb of his mother and protected Maharaj Parikshit. And now here, when he was on a verge of death, when he had only 7 days left with him, he simply again took shelter of Krishna, and this time Krishna sent his representative Shukdeva Goswami to deliver Maharaj Parikshit. And Shukdeva Goswami spoke Srimad Bhagavatam. So when Shukdeva Goswami saw that Maharaj Parikshit was eager to hear about Krishna Katha, so he then started narrating. He said that when Krishna was only 3 years old and he was just trying to turn backside up, so he was even attempting to crawl at that time, and Mother Yashoda wanted to observe a festival in this regard. Anything with regards to Krishna, a festival has been arranged. Krishna moves, if they want to have a festival. Even in our Krishna consciousness, we see that wherever we go, the festivals are always there. We have feast all the time. So sometimes people might ask outsiders that you eat a lot. But if you see here, we eat a lot, but what to do? We enjoy Krishna consciousness. This is way to enjoy Krishna. This is way to enjoy Krishna Prasad. And this is an activity of bhakti. So, when Krishna was just 3 months old and he was trying to crawl and trying to turn backside up, Yashoda wanted to observe a ritualistic ceremony with her friends. And so she invited and organized a big festival. And such ritualistic ceremonies are generally performed with ladies, those who have small children. So when Mother Yashoda saw that Krishna was falling asleep, so what did she do? She took Krishna and put him inside underneath a cart called a shakata. And while the child was still sleeping, and she engaged, when she saw that Krishna is not sleeping very peacefully, she decided to engage herself in other activities. So she went and, because there are so many guests in the home, so she decided, let me go and welcome them first. Let me take care of them. Now the boy is sleeping now. There is no worry. And what happened? Then today's verse. Adha shayanasya shishonal kalpa pralavarumdu angrihatam vyavarata vidhasvata nanarasa kuppibhajanam vyatasta chakra aksha vibhinna kubharam. Now we might have heard many times about people being haunted by ghosts. Now having no material gross body, this ghost, they try to take shelter of a gross body to stay in and haunt. So Shakatasur was actually a ghost and who had taken shelter of this cart and was looking for an opportunity to perform mischief with Krishna. And when Krishna kicked the cart with his small and very delicate legs, the ghost was immediately pushed down to the earth, and Krishna actually purposely made the whole big noise. So the whole shelter which was there, it all dismantled. So Vishwanath Chakri Thakur, he is mentioning that when Lord Krishna was only tender age, very small, how was he able to, and how was Krishna's legs and hands? They're very soft, like new leaves, very very soft. If you see a person who is just 6 days or 7 days old boy, newly born, his hands are very very soft, and we, even while picking the child up, we have to be very very careful, otherwise our arms might not trouble that little boy. So his hands and legs were as soft as new leaves, but yet simply by touching the hand cart with its legs, what happened? The cart fell into pieces. Krishna just touched it and it fell into pieces and it made a big sound. So now there is a question that how is it possible for Krishna to act in such a way? Now Vishwanath Chakri Thakur used an example of Vamana Dev. Now he is making a comparison between this incarnation of Krishna and the various other incarnations, especially he focuses on Vamana avatar. He is saying that when the Lord was Vamana, he had to extend his feet to let's say the greatest height to penetrate the covering of the universe, to cover the three worlds. He actually became Trivikrama. Vamana became Trivikrama. But what happened? And Krishna had to exhibit a special kind of energy for that. And then he says that, Vishwanatha Thakur is saying that for Hiranyakashipu, the Lord had to take a special form of Narsingadev. So special energy is required. But if you see here in this Krishna avatara, the Lord did not exert any such energy. He simply flicked, he just skipped, and the demon was killed. So Vishwanatha Thakur is making a comparison here that this is Krishna. This is Krishna's to Bhagavan Swayam. Krishna is the supreme personality of Godhead. In other incarnations, the Lord had to exert some energy according to the time and circumstances. But in this form, he exhibited unlimited potency. And thus the hand card collapsed and its joint broken. And all the metal pots and utensils were scattered. So, here is the supreme personality of Godhead. You see the quality of the Supreme Lord. What quality can be visible here? That although the demons like Shaktasur, Tranavat or Putana will decrease themselves. Putana also increased their size. Tranavat came like a whirlwind. And Shaktasur sat on the Shakat. So these demons, they increase their bodily size and with the help of their mystical abilities. And thus, they want to gain proportionate power. But the Supreme Lord, how is he? Does he have to expand himself here? No. Krishna is the original personality of Godhead and he is a child or a grown-up man, he is the same person. Krishna is as powerful when he is a child or as powerful when he is speaking Bhagavad Gita in the Kurukshetra. He is the same person, same powerful personality. Whereas the demons, they have to increase their height, they have to increase their abilities. So here Vishwanatha Thakur and other acharyas, they have made this wonderful comparison. So therefore, the greatly powerful demons, they expanded their body, whereas the Krishna remained as a small child. And what else we can see? We can see that after Putana was killed, Krishna fearlessly was playing on the breast of Putana. And then when Trinavat took Krishna on the sky, he was enjoying the sky view. He was fearless. So this, by this we can observe the qualities of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Now how is Krishna? So the Supreme Lord Shadaishwarya Purna. Krishna is the Supreme Lord in all his potencies. Regardless of whether he is present in this form or that form, his potencies are always in full. And he can display all his potencies under any circumstances. Not that when he is a child, he has some limited potencies to exhibit. No. Even though he is a child, he can still display all the potencies. So this is the Supreme Lord Shri Krishna, and it is different from other incarnations of the Supreme Lord. Now, the Supreme Lord, he takes various incarnations. And Supreme Lord has various incarnations and they all descend to these planets, this material world, in different species of life. Varaha avatar, Matsya avatar. And each incarnation, it has some specific purpose or specific missions to be fulfilled. Now sometimes what happens, he comes himself and sometimes he comes with his different planetary portions or the parts of planetary portions or differentiated portions directly or indirectly empowered by him. Now each of them when they come, they have specific functions to perform. But if you see, originally the Lord is full of opulences, all prowess, all fame, all beauty, all knowledge and all renunciation. But when He partly manifests his plenary portions or the parts of plenary portions. It should be noted that certain manifestations of his different powers are required only to perform some kind of particular functions. So all his potency is not manifested in all the incarnations. A day-to-day example. When in the room small electric bulbs are displayed, it does not mean that the electric powerhouse has a capacity to only display light a small bulb. No, it has unlimited capacity. It has enough power to even operate a large scale industry's dynamos. But wherever it is necessary, if a small bulb is necessary, so the power supply is given to small bulb and the work is getting done. And whenever there is a large supply is needed, the large supply is provided. Similarly, the incarnations of the Lord display unlimited powers because so much power is needed at that particular time. For example, Parshuram and Lord Narasingadev, say they both displayed unusual act of killing demons. Lord and Kshatriyas. So Parshuram, he killed disobedient Kshatriyas 21 times. And then Lord Narasingadev killed Hiranyakashipu and so many 85,000 demons who were associated with Hiranyakashipu. So Hiranyakashipu was so powerful that even the demigods in other planets will tremble simply by the unfavorable raising of the eyebrow of Hiranyakashipu. So Hiranyakashipu and the Kshatriyas were killed by Parshuram and Narasingadev in this fashion. So, when Hiranyakashipu was cut into small pieces, the Lord used only the nails. Narasingadev only used the nails. This means that anyone materially powerful just cannot stand with the strength of the Lord's nails. So although Hiranyakashipu might be very, very powerful, but at that particular time he used his opulence, the Lord only exhibited the power of his nails and killed Hiranyakashipu, indicating that however powerful he was, but I am just killing him by my nails. What's the big deal? Similarly, when Parshuram displayed the Lord's power to kill all the disobedient kings, which are powerfully situated in respective states, he also used his anger and he used his axe to kill. Now, similarly, there are different incarnations which perform different activities, like Narada and the planetary incarnation Varaha, and also the empowered incarnation Lord Buddha. They created faith in the mass of people. The incarnations like Rama and Dhanvantari displayed their fame. And Balram, Mohini and Vamana exhibited their beauty. Dattatreya, Matsa, Kurma and Kapila exhibited their transcendental knowledge. And Narayan Rishis exhibited their renunciation. So all the different indirectly or indirectly empowered incarnation of the Lord manifested different features. But Lord Krishna is the primeval Lord and he exhibited complete features of Godhead, and thus therefore it is Vishwanatha Chakra Thakur says in the purport in the commentary that this is Krishna's to Bhagwan Swayam. This is the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. So Srimad Bhagavatam, it relates this transcendental pastimes in the 10th canto, and in order to reach the position to understand the transcendental nature of Lord Krishna's pastimes, one have to take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. Now Srimad Bhagavatam is the book incarnation of Lord Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam is not an ordinary book. It is non-different from Krishna. Krishna Swadhama Pagate Dharma Gyanadibisaha Kalau Nashta Mrushadesha Puranarko Adanoditaha. Sutta Goswami is saying this. When Krishna disappeared, what happened? When Krishna disappeared, Krishna invested all his power and he again came back as Srimad Bhagavatam. So with Srimad Bhagavatam is always there with us in the form of a book incarnation. When Uddhava, he met Krishna during his final pastimes, when Uddhava understood that Krishna is now winding up his pastimes, at that time he pleaded to Krishna, please do not go. Please do not go. What will happen? Imagine this is Dwapara Yuga was going on, and you can see the situation now. Kali Yuga is going to start. What is going to happen with the people? They're completely going to drag themselves in sense enjoyment. So, my dear Lord, if you are there, there will be some hope to revive their Krishna consciousness. So the Lord says, no, I have to go, but I will invest my power in Srimad Bhagavatam. I will come again. For to doing what? Kalau Nastamrsha Desha. To completely destroy the darkness. So if one takes shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam, what will happen? We will get a chance, we will get an opportunity to associate with great personalities, the great Mahabhagavatas. The Srimad Bhagavatam is a live literature. It is not a book like Harry Potter. It is not a concocted book. No, this is a live literature. All the pastimes are alive. And if you want to associate with Krishna, if you want to associate with great personalities like Dhruva Maharaj, Prahlada Maharaj, Pandavas, Shukadeva Goswami, then if you want to associate with Suta Goswami, if you want to associate with personalities like Jada Bharat and Krishna's various incarnations, then you have to simply take shelter of Srimad Bhagavatam. There are three ways of serving Srimad Bhagavatam. One is simply by hearing from those whose life is Srimad Bhagavatam. You have to hear from such personalities and hear it with rapt attention. And then read them. Srila Prabhupada has taken a lot of effort to write commentaries on Srimad Bhagavatam. So we can take a little effort and at least read a certain portion of Srimad Bhagavatam every day. So this is the second way of serving Srimad Bhagavatam, is by reading. And third is by speaking about it, by glorifying the Lord. Glorifying the Lord, His activity, His form and pastimes amongst the association of the devotees. So this way, we can serve Srimad Bhagavatam by hearing, by reading and by speaking about it. Whenever we get a chance to speak, why not speak about Krishna? Let's try to speak about Krishna. Whenever we have some eagerness to read, why not we read Srimad Bhagavatam? So one might ask, oh, we don't have taste for reading. So again the same question, if you don't have taste for reading, what should we do? Read more and more and more, so that we develop taste for reading. So this Srimad Bhagavatam is a very attractive literature. It's very attractive. It attracted personalities like Shukadeva Goswami. Shukadeva Goswami, he was a muni. When he took birth, he did not undergo any kind of purificatory process. He just came out from the womb of his mother and started walking straight to the forest. But what happened? Vedavyas had a purpose to bring Shukadeva Goswami in this world, and the purpose was to spread the glories of Bhagavatam. Because Vedavyas, he wrote the Vedas, he wrote Puranas, Itihas, and distributed it to the various of his disciples to propagate the teachings. But when he compiled Srimad Bhagavatam under the guidance of Narad Muni, he could not find anybody qualified for spreading these glories of Bhagavatam. That's why he prayed to the Supreme Lord, and Shukadeva Goswami was born. But now Shukadeva Goswami is born, and when he is born, he just walks straight to the forest. So now what to do? Vedavyas made an attempt to bring him back by running behind him, but it was a big failure. So Vedavyas devised a trick. He called two of his disciples and taught them two verses from the Bhagavatam and said that go and recite this in the forest. Aho vakiyam stanakala kutam, and then varaha piram natvar vapu karnayo karani karam. So these disciples, they went and sang these two verses of Srimad Bhagavatam in the forest. And Shukadeva Goswami, who was situated in trance, who was already experiencing Brahmananda, when he heard Krishna's glories, when he heard how Krishna delivered Putana, when he heard how Krishna's form is, Shukadeva Goswami went back to those people and said, where are these verses from? And the disciple said, please go and ask our Gurudev. So he went back to Vyasadev, and Vyasadev made him sit down. There are 18,000 verses to be discussed, so sit down. So Srimad Bhagavatam is so powerful that it even attracts the liberated souls. So what has to be said about us? A conditioned soul who are wandering around in this material world, if they hear about Krishna, will they not be attracted by, will they not become a Premi Bhaktas? Definitely. If a liberated personality who is experiencing Brahmananda gets attracted to Srimad Bhagavatam, we are not getting any ananda. But if we hear Krishna, if we hear Srimad Bhagavatam very nicely, then we will definitely be attracted and become Premi Bhaktas of Lord Krishna. So this is Srimad, hearing Srimad Bhagavatam is one of the five important process which may mentioned by Rupa Goswami Pad. And with this wealth of this weapon of Srimad Bhagavatam, His Divine Grace S.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada traveled to the West. When he went to West, what did he had with him? Srimad Bhagavatam. What did he do there? Simply glorified the form, activities of the Supreme Lord. And these activities are so powerful, the Lord's glories are so powerful, when it enters the ears of conditioned souls, it transforms them. So Srila Prabhupada took this message of Srimad Bhagavatam to the West, and he glorified the Supreme Lord, his activities, form and pastimes in midst of everyone. And when they heard this, when they heard Kirtan, when they heard the Srimad Bhagavatam, they all become attracted to Krishna. And they all become devotees. Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur, he said that if all the books in the world are to be destroyed, but only Srimad Bhagavatam remains, the Srimad Bhagavatam is sufficient itself to give us everything. Even Vyasadev, he says, Srimad Bhagavate Mahamuni Krute Kimva Parerishvara Sadhyoradiya Vridyatta Kruti Bhi Sushrushubhita Kshanat. Simply by mere desire to hear Srimad Bhagavatam, mere desire. The Supreme Lord is willing to get bound up by the devotee. He is ready. So what happens if we hear Srimad Bhagavatam on a regular basis by making it as a life and soul? Our lives will be completely transformed. So this is the glories, and with this purpose only, Srila Prabhupada wanted that this every day there should be some hearing of Bhagavatam. Every day we discuss one purport, at least. This is minimum. Just like chanting 16 rounds is minimum. That doesn't mean that we cannot chant more rounds. We should definitely be chanting more rounds. Similarly, at least the members of our Krishna Consciousness Society, ISKCON, can at least discuss one verse every day. That's why I started this system. But that we should not minimize ourselves with that only. Getting inspiration from this, we should read on everyday basis, regular basis, and make Srimad Bhagavatam as our life and soul. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Yes, Prabhuji. If you have any questions, Mike. Can somebody help Prabhu with mic?
Hare Krishna. I can speak and you can translate.
Yes, yes.
I can speak Hindi.
Okay, you can speak in Hindi, no problem.
So, jaise aapne kaha ki Bhagwan Sri Krishna keval 3 mahine ke the aur chakre ko सत्ता को मारने में कोई अपना रूप नहीं बदलना पड़ा
जी।
विष्णु चक्र ठाकुर ने कहा है
जी,
हिरण्यकश्यप को मारने के लिए बदलना पड़ा और वामन भगवान बनना पड़ा उनको
जी,
लेकिन कृष्ण केवल 3 महीना के जैसे बालक थे उसी रूप में सत्ता को बदल दिया
जी,
कि भगवान बहुत बड़े शक्तिशाली थे। वैसे उसमें भी भगवान की शक्ति का इतना वर्णन स्वयं भगवान शिव ने कहा है, मैंने स्कंद में जब दुर्वासा जी अपनी रक्षा के लिए गए थे उपनिषदों के पास, जब चक्रों के पीछे लगा हुआ था
जी
अम्बरीश महाराज के अपराध की वजह से, तो भगवान शिव ने कहा कि उनका चक्र है जिनके केवल संकल्प मात्र से ही अनेकों ब्रह्मांड बनते हैं और संकल्प मात्र से अनेकों ब्रह्मांड लोकपालों में से नष्ट हो जाते हैं। इतने शक्तिशाली उनका चक्र है तो इससे रक्षा नहीं कर सकते। तो वास्तव में भगवान श्री कृष्ण बहुत शक्तिशाली है, जो आपने कहा उनका उदाहरण दिया इसमें चक्र टावर का
जी।
तो आप थोड़े हिंदी बता सकते हैं, इंग्लिश में करें।
तो आपको प्रश्न क्या है?
प्रश्न ये है कि वास्तविक भगवान शक्तिशाली इतने हैं कि असीमित केवल संकल्प मात्र ही कुछ कर सकते हैं
जी।
संकल्प मात्र से ही सबको नष्ट कर सकती होगा
जी।
तो भगवान श्री ने स्वयं कहा है कि भगवान श्री कृष्ण के शक्तिशाली है
जी,
कि केवल उनके संकल्प मात्र से ही
जी जी
अनेकों अनेकों ब्रह्मांड की सृष्टि होती है, केवल संकल्प मात्र से ही, और संकल्प मात्र से ही अनेकों ब्रह्मांड लोक वालों में से नष्ट हो जाते हैं
जी जी।
इतनी असीम शक्ति होगा
जी। तो आपका प्रश्न यही है ना कि कमेंट है, कमेंट है, ठीक है। सो प्रभु इज़ अ वेरी लर्नेड डिवोटी, ही इज़ ऑलवेज अब्सॉर्ब्ड इन श्रीमद् भागवतम, सो शेयरिंग हिज कमेंट्स दैट कृष्णा सिंपली बाय हिज मियर डिज़ायर कैन डू एवरीथिंग, स्टिल ही परफॉर्म्स दिस पास्ट टाइम्स एंड ही कोटेड दिस दैट हाउ ही कोटेड लॉर्ड शिवा सेइंग दिस। So that was his comment, that Krishna, although he is very powerful and he has to grow his, as Vaman he has to increase his size, increase his height, and Narasingha he has to appear as a lion, but he is saying that Krishna is powerful and simply by his desire he can do so many things, but still he performs. Yes, any other questions or comments? Yes, Mother Ji.
Did you forgive this or this or reflect you if practically here at Mother Ji? There is a group of devotees distributing the Bhagavata. There are some devotees who distribute the Shrimad Bhagavata here in Vrindavan, right?
I don't understand you, Mataji.
Are there a group of devotees who are distributing Shrimad Bhagavatam?
Distributing?
Yes.
Where?
Here.
You should ask Saran Thakur Prabhu. He will have more information of this. You want to distribute books?
You distribute already with Shrimad Bhagavatam.
Okay. So you should ask Saran Thakur Prabhu. Is you should ask him. He is the Sankirtan man. Hare Krishna. Any other questions? Okay. Thank you. Granthraj Shrimad Bhagavatam ki.